Hi boys and girls, today you are working on your flag art inspired by Jasper John's three flags painting. We're actually going to make two flags for our painting and we are going to use tempera paint. We're going to water it down and actually do a tempera paint wash today. So you're going to be using some bigger brushes and we're going to be doing actually two paintings.
I've been painting for many years and October 2011, a little voice, my muse, came to me and just quietly said, paint the flag. So I painted an American flag, and then I painted another flag and another American flag. I called it the Oh Beautiful series because the flag is so beautiful. And then one day I just thought, well, I saw this vision of, I want that whole wall of flags. That's what I see. So I just focused and have painted the flag ever since. I'm into my second year now. A life-changing experience for me in that you don't learn to paint, you paint to learn. And the flag keeps teaching me. There are so many variations on the same theme. Every time you look at the flag, it's waving and it's different, but it's the same. And not only as an artist, but philosophically and spiritually, it's focusing on the spirit of freedom and the choice. I have a choice every day. What am I going to paint? And I choose to paint the flag. Being a painter, I'm humbled, and it's a privilege to paint the American flag. And all I can say is look up and just appreciate what you have in your life with gratitude and humility. And it's the stars and stripes. They're up there.
As I'm painting the flag, every day I paint the flag, it gives me time to be quiet and have some thoughts. And one of the thoughts that has gone through my mind is that as we identify with things in our lives, like the flag, things touch us. And it seems to me that as I paint the flag, sometimes I get up in the morning and I think, you know, the flag gets up every day. I am the flag. The flag gets up in the morning, I get up in the morning. Face the day, the flag faces the day into the wind as I do. The challenges that come at you, like the wind coming at the flag, either knock you back and you bounce back and you go forward again. The flag stands there confidently as you do. The flag is beautiful as you are. The flag stands for something as you do, as I do, whatever that may be. And that's another thing to think about. What do we stand for? The flag symbolically stands for such wonderful characteristics. Integrity, strength of character, honesty, freedom, all these wonderful characteristics. And so I think about the flag as being so related to who I am and the country that I live in, that it becomes personal. And that's the way I paint the flag, up close and personal. So it becomes more than just red, white, and blue flying out there in the distance. It becomes connected to my daily life and how I face my day, how I am, and how I am perceived by others, just as you. And that's really important when all is said and done in one's life. And so painting the flag, this is just some of the thoughts that go through the artist's mind as I push around that paint. And it's so interesting. The flag is giving me so much as it gives you so much every day.
Jessica Henry here. Wanted to say hello and have a very happy Memorial Day weekend. I thought I'd sort of celebrate that today with doing something a little bit fun. I'm just going to focus on painting an American flag. I thought it'd be kind of cool just to share how I would just focus on one thing. I am going to get in. I've got a sketch. I did just a thumbnail. Whenever you're working on anything that is moving, you want to try to capture it quick with a drawing, like ocean waves, an animal, or in this case, this flag does not hold still. A couple of words also about plein air painting. You want to make sure to bring your paper towels. And I actually had to go home and change. I was wearing a bright blue shirt, but what happens is if the colors of your clothes can bounce off on your canvas and can affect the choices you make in your color mixing. So I just threw on a neutral shirt, and it makes a difference. Also, your hat. Right on the inside of this brim, a lot of times in some other hats, you get like green or reds or whatever up in here, and that can affect your visual, what you see peripherally, and it can affect your color choices that you mix. So I try to keep this just really neutral. This is gray. Some of my other hats are white. Or just tan, and then it doesn't really affect your color choices at all. So, two things there to pay attention to. And also, when you're out, I'm in the direct sun here, and it's about 85, pushing upper 80s today. It's pretty hot, and stay hydrated, really. I have water down here, and get your sunblock. This is a long sleeve shirt. I'm pretty fair skinned, so, you know, you do what you can. Stripes are going this direction. You always want to hold your brush very loose at the beginning, because you don't want to get in there and get all finicky with little things, and then it can get away from you. I hold it very loose because I'm looking at everything as a whole. I'm at a park, so they're doing all things of lawn care and whatever, so lots of noises. That's part of the plein air experience, right? I was thinking when I was on the way over here how much this holiday, Memorial Day, means to me. My daughter is marching in a Memorial Day parade on Monday, and she just signed up for the Army Reserve, so she leaves for boot camp in literally 2 weeks, or just about, June 12th. So, it's emotional. So much. Right here. Now we'll do some of this lighter red area. All right, starting to feel like, oops, like a flag. Motorcycles, everybody's out and about. And I'm just going around the flag like this, and just letting it kind of choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo. It's my favorite part of this painting. A couple years ago, I did a video painting fun backgrounds. This was something that I did in there. It was just so much fun. A little yellow ochre, whatever. You gotta be careful though, because if a little's good, then a lot's better. Yeah, so you just don't want to overdo it. Now, I'm gonna take my little brush and just a little bit of yellow ochre, burnt sienna, a little white. There's some green or whatever stuff on the palette. I'm just going to throw in some blue. I'm going to suggest the pole here. If you run out of paint, tip your brush over. Cleaning up some of that just to create that feeling of movement. There. All right. Well, so there's that. And I hope that this has been fun and enjoyable, and that you had a good time.
with a dream, my cardigan. Welcome to the land of fame excess. Am I gonna fit in? Jumped in the cab, here I am for the first time. Look to my right and I see the Hollywood sign. This is all so crazy. Everybody seems so famous. My tummy's turning and I'm feeling kinda homesick. Too much pressure and I'm nervous. That's when the taxi man turned on the radio. And a Jay-Z song was on. And a Jay-Z song was on. And a Jay-Z song was on. So I put my hands up to play my song. The butterflies fly away. Nodding my head like yeah. Moving my hips like yeah. Got my hands up to play my song. We know I'm gonna be okay. Yeah. It's a party in the USA. Yeah. It's a party in the USA. Get to the club in my taxi cab. Everybody's looking at me now. Like, who's that chick that's rocking kicks? She gotta be from out of town. So hard with my girls not around me. It's definitely not a Nashville party. Cause all I see is the letters. I guess I never got the memo. My tummy's turning and I'm feeling kinda homesick. Too much pressure and I'm nervous. That's when the DJ drummed my favorite tune. And the Britney song was on. And the Britney song was on. And the Britney.
Hello, this is Angela Anderson. Thank you for joining me today. On this video, I'm going to be doing a special patriotic tribute. We're doing an American flag with a peace dove over the top. And I've covered my canvas with some newspaper, just different headlines. There's all kinds of, this is one day in the news right here. It had all kinds of crazy events happening all over the world. Rape survivors, ISIS, gun control, economy problems, murder, everything. Just, there's so many negative headlines in the news that I thought, you know, the original painting that I did of this was for the 9/11 tribute, 10-year anniversary, and I used clippings from that day's paper remembering 9/11, and the whole idea was just the symbolic, covering it with the flag, the bleeding flag, and praying for peace over the top of it. So you can do this for any country that you want to. It can be adapted for wherever in the world you're at. I just thought this was a good time for the 4th of July coming up in a couple of weeks, and we've had so many other things in the news lately that have been so disturbing. I just wanted to kind of pull this out. It's been about 5 years since I painted it, and do this for you today. So I hope you enjoy it. And I don't really do like symbolic type art like this very often, but when I do, it was really, I mean, I think that painting this, the original painting, I did it live also at church. I was asked to do a painting for the anniversary of 9/11. It happened to fall on a Sunday, and I had been doing live paintings from time to time during the service, and so I don't know, this was just one of those things that kind of came together for me. It's really, I wish it happened more often when I get an idea like this and it just works, you know, but it was probably one of the more profound experiences that I've had painting, doing this one live at church. It was very, very moving. Just the symbolism of it, you know, just the idea of covering over all of this tragedy. I'm going to grab some red paint. This is pyrrole red. You can use whatever red you've got. And I'm going to just lightly go back and forth. And I'm using I think it's probably a half inch flat here, number 12, Robert Simmons. So I'm going to do my middle three first, my top one, my middle one, and then my bottom one. And then I can adjust the sizes, try to keep them kind of narrow at first. And okay, so now for our flag. And like I said, you can kind of adapt this to whatever country you're from. I would just keep it very impressionist. Like, don't get too bogged down in all of the little details. I'm kind of doing a general representation of the flag, but I'm not trying to be really perfect about the lines or anything. So with the American flag, there are seven red stripes down the middle. The middle one is right smack dab in the middle, and it runs into the blue. So that will be the bottom of your blue section. And then the blue section's about, it's less than half of the top. So I'm just going to kind of do a general section here. Let me see. So it's a little bit longer this way than it is this way. Does that make sense? That's why I'm using the longer canvas. You could do this on a smaller canvas and just kind of adjust it accordingly. But so then the top and bottom stripes are going to go right along the edge, and then you're going to fit two more stripes right in the middle of those. It's actually a really fun, pretty fast project. I think I painted it in under an hour when I did it at the church. Okay, see? And I don't want it to go too thick so that I can still see some of my words underneath as well. So I don't know what we're gonna do for 4th of July this year. Both of our boys are not living in, well, both of our older boys that were like in charge of the fireworks festivities are both not in living in town anymore. So we're going to have to do our own. Our neighborhood does a huge fireworks stuff. Like fireworks are illegal. So people just grab hundreds of dollars worth of fireworks and do them off all over in our neighborhood. This is ultramarine blue. And I'm going to add a little bit of phthalo blue also, because I found that these two colors together make a really nice, like, royal blue. And I'm just going to fill in this whole top section with this. So, yeah, we've had some interesting 4th of Julys at our house. We've had some interesting fireworks mishaps happened.
Hopefully nobody hurt, though.
Yeah, nobody hurt, but we did catch the neighbor's yard on fire a couple of times.
No.
They were nice about it at least, but yeah, so that happened and almost blew up a car, but that was for a birthday. That wasn't 4th of July. So yes, so be safe. Don't, if you're using fireworks, be safe about it. Have adult supervision. Don't let teenagers loose with the, we caught our boys with their friends taping bottle rockets together with duct tape. They had like about 200 of them. They had made this huge bottle rocket bomb. Like, yeah, no, that's being confiscated right now. What the heck, dudes? Okay, so now I'm going to put in some stars, really simple. Got some white here. And I've grabbed I think it's like a quarter inch. It's a flat brush. It's got longer bristles. Really doesn't matter what brush you use, as long as you can kind of get it into these tight spaces. So we've got to look at my notes here. So there's six across. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 5 down. One, I'm going to do there. Nope, that's wrong, is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, that's right. Okay. So 6 across and 5 down. I'm just doing little dabs. If you haven't joined my Thankful Art Group, it's a really nice place for where you can share with me what you're painting. If you've done any of my art tutorials, I'd like to see what you're doing. And there's a lot of really nice people in there that are very encouraging. We're all kind of on our different art journeys and could use some encouragement sometimes. So it's just a nice place. There's no critiques unless you ask for them. Just a place to kind of share and your excitement about what you're painting. And try to keep the drama down to a minimum. So we've had, every now and then we have a spammer or somebody weird get in there that tries to cause trouble, but they get booted out pretty quick. Yeah. We don't do drama. It's got to be a nice, I can't paint when I'm stressed, so I'm sure neither can you. I'm just doing a little flaggy. Oh, I forgot to do my little close-up camera. Let me see if this is going to work. Oh, look at that. All right, now we're talking. I'm going to have to click off my picture. There we go. I forgot all about it.
Yeah, I'm trying to get all fancy.
I am. I've got a second camera now. Really, I'm taking more time with this than I did with my other one, but so there you get the idea. It's just an artistic choice, really. You can do it however you want. If you want it a little bit more perfect, this one was kind of, the idea was sort of that the flag was a little bit deconstructed, bleeding and, you know, broken. So just mourning more, you know. I mean, the idea was that for the 9/11 painting that I did originally was just, you know, mourning for the losses that we'd had, and you know, with all the craziness that's been going on lately with Orlando and all this other stuff, I just thought, you know, this is a good time to pull this out and remember, just pray for peace. Hope you've enjoyed this. Thank you so much for those who came and stopped by to watch, and I will see you next week. مکن بستری از گل بسازیم، برای کوچه شب هنگام وحشت کمک کن، با تن هم گل بسازیم، کمک کن سایه بونیم از ترانه، برای خواب ابیشم بسازیم، کمک کن با کلام عاشقانه، برای زخم شب مرحب بسازی، بذار قسمت کنیم تنهای مونو میون صفره شب تو با من، بذار بین من و تو دستای ما پلی باشه واسه از خود گذشتن، بذار قسمت کنیم تنهای مونو میون صفره شب تو با من، بذار بین من و تو دستای ما پلی باشه واسه از خود گذشتن. تو رو میشناسم ای شبگرد عاشق، تو با اسم شب من آشنایی، از اندوه تو با چشم تو پیداست که از ایل و تبار عاشقایی، تو رو میشناسم ای سردر گریبو، غریبگی نکن با حقیق من، تن شکستت رو بسپار به دست نوازش های دست عاشق من، بذار قسمت کنیم تنهاییمونو میون صفره شب تو با من، بذار بین من و تو دستای ما پلی باشه واسه از خود گذشتن، بذار قسمت کنیم تنهاییمونو میون صفره شب تو با من، بذار بین من و تو دستای ما پلی باشه واسه از خود گذشتن.